Hey, what is up, dudes? My name is Freaky, and let's sit back and relax as we dig deep into my memories of a video called Story Times. And today we're going to be touching on a story of the first time that I went into high school. Now, this gameplay is pretty impressive. It is pretty impressive. I go 8-23. And I'm just kidding with you guys. I couldn't even keep that in a straight face. But actually, this is a 100 plus fail. And it's on instinct. And I can't remember. I'm using the HBR, I believe. And in the second half, I lose my momentum. It kind of goes downhill. And I'm like, oh, crap. And I end up going 90-11. So this is my highest killing score yet in Advanced Warfare. Hope you guys keep your eyes glazed on your freaking computer screen or your tablet or your mobile device or anything that you're watching it on. You could have made, you know, an internet device that's watching my video right now out of dirt, and I'd be happy if you just did that. So, pretty much, it's an amazing gameplay. This channel's not about gameplay, but today, it's about the story time. So, a lot of you guys have been requesting for a story time, so here's one for you today. But if you guys missed any of the story times videos, there'll be a link to a playlist below that you guys can go check out and watch all the other story times videos down below. And they're also located on my channel, just in case if you guys missed them or if this is your first time ever seeing a story time on my channel. Now, today, like I said, we're going to be hinting on my first high school experience. And let me just tell you, wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Spoilers alert, it wasn't a good time. Now, let's touch on my past before I went to high school. Now, I grew up in a school that was kind of like a private Christian school. So if you don't know what a Christian is, it's like a Lutheran where you believe in Jesus and all hail the mighty God. And I pretty much went to one of those schools, and it was a first through eighth grade school. Which means that everyone knew each other, right? Everyone knew each other. Everyone grew up with each other. And the classes were about 20 to 30 kids per class, which means that the school held around 200 kids max, maybe. Maybe somewhere lower than that. It depends on how many kids were in each grade. But that's pretty much how it was. And when it hit around 8th grade, we had this thing in our class where everybody kind of knew where you were going to high school. Everyone had that hype for high school. They're like, oh my god, hashtag hype for high school, even though I don't even think Twitter was really, it might have been around, but I don't know. But yeah, so everyone got to pick on their bulletin board what high school you guys were going to, and it wasn't like a guaranteed thing, like you guys were just kind of saying where you might go. And there's most of the people are going to Lutheran High School, and some of the people are splitting up, going to other high schools, and I was left alone by myself going to a high school all alone. So knowing people that you're growing up with for about 8 years, right, going into a different school, a completely different school, a completely different city than where I am. The city is actually is located 25 minutes away from where I live. So going from a whole different city, not knowing either anybody that lives in that city, and not knowing anyone that goes to that school, completely mind blown. Holy fuck, what the hell am I supposed to do? Am I supposed to just, you know, act cool and make friends? Or what am I supposed to do in this scenario, right? What am I supposed to do? So I'm really afraid. I don't know what I'm going to do. This is my first time ever having to really, you know, express myself a little bit more to make friends in the long run of this 4 years called high school hell, which is about to go down. So pretty much, eighth grade year is over. It's over, sauce. It's just done. Dunzo, gonzo, and it's done. Now, I'm pretty afraid. I remember in the summer before high school started, I was working out a lot, and I was probably like 120 pounds. I was about 5'4". I didn't really start getting to my height right now until I was, you know, probably freshman-ish area, sophomore, and I was 120 pounds, 5'4", and going into high school, and I was working out. I was like, I gotta pump myself up. I gotta look big and intimidating, and maybe I can become a jock. And I remember, my dad thought it was a good idea if I joined the football team. So before, in the summer, there's a football little camp, little tryouts and stuff like that, that you go to, you know, just to train out for football, and if they want you or if you want to be on the football team. So I ended up going there, and now this is my first time ever going to that high school and never knowing anyone that's there. I don't know anybody at all. So we're driving around for about 20 minutes around the school trying to find out where this freaking goddamn football tryouts is, and I finally figure out where it is, and I'm just thinking to myself, I don't want to be here. Come on. I don't want to play football right now. I'm not even in the mood. I don't know these people, so how am I going to bond with these people by playing football? And all the people that were in the football team were kind of jackasses. So it's like, do I want to become friends with these jackasses so I become a jackass? No, I don't want to do that. So I end up telling my dad, I'm like, screw this. I'm not doing it. I leave my cleats there in the locker room, and I'm like, fuck this. I'm not getting naked in front of these dumbasses. So when the year progresses, the first day of high school comes about. Now, I don't know what the fuck I'm supposed to do. I don't know. Frankly honest, I walk through the doors and I'm scared as fuck. There's so many people. The school is huge. There's about 4,000 kids there, at least, somewhere around that area. And me, singled out, don't know anybody. So what do? Start walking around, scared. I go straight to my class because I'm like, screw it, man. I'm going straight to my class. I don't know what I need to do. And Spanish. Spanish is my first class, right? So I'm sitting in Spanish, and okay, obviously, in the first day of school, they always like, oh, hey, let's all communicate, and let's all get to know each other, and let's all tell each other's names, and, you know, where they live, and your social security number, and, you know, how much money you make per year, but, like, all these weird little factual things, but not really, but, you all want to know each other, right? So that's what the teachers always do, like, you guys need to know each other. So we end up, you know, getting that social thing, and me being afraid, I'm like, I don't know anybody, I don't want to talk to these people. I kind of clam up, and for me, I used to, back in high school, I used to have super bad social anxiety, to the point where I would literally shake when I was talking, and I couldn't move my muscles, so my muscles would tighten up in my neck, and it would just not be well. So I was like, oh, I don't want to have this happen to me. So I pretty much ditched out of that class. I said that I didn't need to go to the bathroom, and I ended up ditching that class, and I didn't come back that hour. And pretty much after that, a couple hours pass, and lunch comes around. Now, lunch is after my, I think it was health class, and I met some people in there. They were sort of nice to me, and I ended up pretty much becoming full-on stalker mode and followed them to their table. And right when I got to their table, I was like, no, I can't do this. I can't be a stalker the first day of school. So I was like, oh, backing out. Take a step back, freak. Take a step back. Okay, let's take a step back. And let's not be full on stalker mode, because then the people are going to think I'm weird as hell. And I probably shouldn't do this. So I end up going and sitting by myself in this weird, huge table next to, like, the lunch lines and everything. And I sat at a loner table, pretty much, by myself. And then this one kid randomly comes up. He eats his pizza right in front of me. And he's probably a loner as well. I didn't say one word to him whatsoever. And I was like, shit, this is going to suck. Because lunch, without any friends, without knowing anybody, sucks so badly. If any of you guys have had that happen to you, I feel really, really bad, because that is like the worst thing ever to happen to you in high school or in any, you know, social scenario. But nowadays it's fine for me. But yeah, so I'm sitting by myself alone. I think I brought a bag lunch from home, so I'm eating this stupid lunch from home. That, you know, that's not the cool thing to do. You're supposed to buy lunch in the lunch cafeteria, right? You're supposed to buy that lunch. So I'm sitting here eating my lunch, and I don't even think I finish it. I think I eat my sandwich, and I'm like, I don't feel like eating. I really don't. And then I just throw away my lunch, and then I go back to class. Now, a couple hours pass, and I end up going into a science class, which is called environmental science. And obviously, all science teachers are, like, super, super into science. They're like, oh, man, science is the greatest subject in the world. Yeah, but you better study, and if you goof off in class, I'm gonna come and stab you with a Bunsen burner. And pretty much you could sneeze on someone in that class, and he would kick you out of the class. It was very, very weird. He was strict on so many different levels, and I don't know why. But I ended up meeting one of my good friends in that class. Shout out to Austin if you're watching this video. But, yeah, as the day progresses on, just a little bit further, we pretty much go until, I think my last hour of the day was engineering, and it was a pretty good class. It was like architectural engineering or something weird like that. I ended up failing that class to begin with, but it didn't matter, because I ended up meeting some people in that class, and this guy that I met ended up being one of my first friends ever in high school, and he ended up being the first friend that I noticed I shouldn't have became friends with, because this guy had a group of friends that were pretty much the douchebags of the school that no one liked. So that in that category. I didn't want to fit in that category. I ended up having to hang out with them for about a couple, you know, months after, until I met my true friends of high school. So after I met him, the day went on, and I was like, oh my god, I can't wait to get home. Let's get home now. Let's get freaking home. Because high school, I don't want to be here. This is like a maximum security prison. I want to go home. These people are going to make me drop the soap, put it in my butt without lube, and it's going to be a goddamn scary time. And I don't want to do this. I don't want to do this. Mom, I want to go home now. I just want to go home. And that's what I wanted to do. That's all I wanted to do. And right when I got on that bus for the first time in my goddamn life, going to my grandparents' house, and waiting for my mom to pick me up, and then going to my aunt's house, because that's what we were doing on that day. I remember exactly what we were doing, and then I had a goddamn double cheeseburger, and it was fantastic, and I just had this huge sigh of relief come off of me, and I just remembered, when I woke up that next morning, I shat myself. You wanna know why? Because I had to do that shit all over again. So this was another Story Times video for you guys. Hope you guys did enjoy it. If you guys want to like remind me or bring up anything in my head, let me know some topics down below in the comment section of this video. Hope you guys did enjoy. Make sure to go check out any of the Story Times videos that you guys may have missed in the description below. And if you guys like this video, make sure to drop it a like. Share this video with friends on Twitter and Facebook. And I guess I will catch your pretty faces in the next video. Today we got a special guest here today, and he's been on my channel for a while now. Why don't you introduce yourself, Chris?
You need to introduce yourself. CR705 here. What is up, guys? I'm here on Q&A.